think my dad was the person that that inspired me because he goes out of town to work, so he didn't really have a good chance to see my games. So every time that, like, the chance that he got to come watch me, and when I would turn back to see at the stands that he was there, I tried to give it my all, and it made me, like, I think a better player in the field because I wanted to impress him more. So he was the one that he gave me, like, that push.
I don't know, it was my effort to just get out of the city. So I put everything aside, stopped partying, stopped everything just to get ourselves to the state finals, which we didn't.
Coach Whitner, because he would push us to the limit and he would tell us that we can go far and believe, like, in us, each other. And Mirei Hernandez, she's a great player, and I want to be like her.
Pues, primero el coach Winner, me inspiró Machine, también el equipo, entre uno que el otro, tenemos el espíritu ahí, y el tuvo por mi papá, mi familia, me inspiraron a seguir adelante, jugar y jugar y jugar.
I guess it was the boys, because they worked so hard and they didn't get where they wanted to. So then that kind of pushed us to where we wanted to, because we saw them not conquer what they wanted, but we went farther, so we were doing it for them and the coaches.
Principalmente el coach, porque nos dio motivación para seguir adelante.
I would have to say my teammates, like, not giving up, or like having this drama in last year and like really wanting it.
El coach Win fue el que más me inspiró porque fue el que siempre me estuvo apoyando en todo.
Mi papá y mi mamá. Mi papá en el fútbol, tratando de ayudarme a mejorar, y mi mamá levantándome cuando cada juego que perdíamos y todos los días que lloraba al perder.
You know, every year I think there's somebody within the team that makes an impact on me, on the decisions I make, on how to support the team. There's always a special person, boy and girl, you know, from our captains to being leaders, to communicating with me, to, you know, certain individuals who just are, you know, want that extra knowledge given to them about the game of soccer, just you know sitting here in the coach's office, you know, from 10 minutes after a game. I've stayed here 2 hours after a game digesting with these players, and I think it's just they impact me because they show the true passion for the game, and they put the impact on me back, so hopefully I can show to them the passion that I have for them. And I think, you know, each individual, each year, there's certain individuals or each game that they give me an impact, and they make me a better coach and hopefully run a better program. And I, you know, instead of saying one individual in particular, I think all of them have made an impact on me to better myself and to better the team.
Your head can't rule your
The most memorable moment would have to be senior night, because it was the last home game that I played with my teammates. It wasn't only the game, but also the pregame. We were in the lockers and we were binding like as a team, and we were telling the girls, the underclassmen, they were telling us how much they were gonna miss us, how we made like an impact in their lives, and how much they cared for us. And it was pretty emotional. And then when the game came up, when we saw our parents and all our fans in the last home game, it was a really like bittersweet feeling. And that was a really good moment, memorable moment.
I think the most memorable moment was the Del Valle game, the playoff game, because it was our first experience and we lost, but it was a good experience to play at that level against a team that made it so far in the state.
And the dancing in the lockers with the girls.
Winning back-to-back championships and last year's game against Jefferson, where we were the actually counted a penalty against us and I had a huge save in which we won.
I guess spending time with my friends together ever since high school started and we got closer.
Oh, pues cuando fuimos a Frisco, nos pasamos suave allá y le dimos con todo. Se sintió un equipo, se sintió que quedamos un gran equipo y siempre fuimos.
I would have to say, like, when we were down by so many goals and then we still catched up, like, the feeling you have, like, the chills, and like, scoring the goals and then getting after them and then actually beating them once we were down, like, 3-0.
Quedar campeón con mi equipo. Poder levantar el trofeo y celebrar con ellos.
The family atmosphere created within the program. There's like brothers and sisters within the teams and everybody just getting along on and off the field. And I think that's just more important to creating a successful program, and they've helped establish that.
Opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choked. He's so mad, but he won't give up. Daddies, he know he won't have it, he knows. His whole back's at these ropes, it don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home.
The funniest moment was when we have like these little dance competitions and I just happened to be dancing all funny, like the way you dance in the shower, like nobody's watching you. And then coach opens the door and then he walked like in, but like we were all dancing and it was just funny because everybody was like, Perla, stop, coach is here. But I just kept on like doing my retarded dances. And then he was just laughing, and that was pretty embarrassing, but it was funny, so so I would have to say that.
Well, the funniest moment in the season was over there in Frisco, in the hotel. I was sleeping, and then some guys came with some shaving cream, and they woke me up, and they hit me in the face with it. It was pretty funny, yeah.
We're in Dallas, and we're in the hotel, and then I think Carla Parra was showering, and then we put a bucket with ice. And she was all crying and we were laughing and is funny.
I guess Abby. Abby, she's blonde, and everywhere, like the games, locker room, everywhere, wherever she's at, she's funny. So yeah, I guess it was Abby.
Bueno, que se ha divertido. Cuando fuimos a Frisco en el locker room, cuando pararon a Obama de pura shaving cream, todo suave.
Cuando hacían tapeless girls, like, que les hacían pranks, o cuando les puso una prank a todos los guys que escondimos, we changed their shoes, no sé, just pranks like that. Or la prank que le hicimos a Coach, just things like that.
El más divertido fue cuando estuvimos en Frisco, porque hicimos muchas locuras. Corriendo en el campo, en las noches escapándonos, no, me éramos bien locos. Y luego en el hotel también, en los cuartos, no nos dormíamos hasta la 1 o 2. Estaba muy emocionante.
Cuando estábamos de viaje en el torneo en Dallas, ahí éramos libres y todos juntos como familia hicimos momentos que nunca vamos a olvidar.
Probably when somebody got my sliding shorts. That was pretty funny that, especially Michelle, that took them and ran around with them, showing off my sliding pants for my soccer gear. But that was probably one of the funniest moments.
Watching the wide world riot and hiding out.
is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you'd found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful. Shoot the bloody ball!
Shoot the bloody ball!
Go for the bloody ball!
Bloody! Bloody! Bloody!
Kick the bloody ball? I don't know.
Kick the bloody ball! Give me the bloody pennies!
Go get the bloody ball!
Hit the bloody ball! Hit the bloody ball! Run!
Get the bloody ball, like that. Something bloody. He always uses that word, bloody.
All the kids that I interviewed today, I asked them all to give me their best imitation of you.
Oh my goodness.
And every single one of them used the same expression. What do you think that expression is?
The bloody ball.
Every single one of them.
We're in his locker, and then we got his tape, and we taped Mirei to the chair. And yeah, we left her like in his office.
I don't know. I really don't remember anything. I really don't. I wouldn't say it in front of the camera, though, if we did.
Maybe running the laps. He would say, run 8 laps, and we run 6. Because it was too much. Maybe it was one of those days we were just tired and he would leave inside. So we're like, no, we're just gonna run 4 instead of 8 or 6 instead of 8.
Que los coaches nunca supieron. No, pues a veces no corríamos y a veces ni practicábamos. Decíamos que sí, decíamos mentiras. Pero puro cotorreo.
I don't know, not that I remember of, probably just like run less laps. I don't know, I wasn't much like that.
Pues sí, de hecho muchas cosas. Por ejemplo, en los hoteles cuando salíamos de viaje, nos salíamos, estábamos más de 4 en un cuarto, a tarde, a horas tarde, nos escondíamos en los baños. A veces nos íbamos de práctica, disque hacer trabajos, pero nomás íbamos a los lockers a estarnos ahí porque sabemos que íbamos a correr y cosas así.
Pues el año pasado cuando estábamos en Aliro nos fuimos a la alberca en la noche, todos.
Is there anything that they did that they think you never found out about, but you probably did?
Probably the boys thinking they got away or jumping hotels, going swimming, that they think they got away with it. I knew about it. once again, I got to pick my battles. We're in an out-of-town tournament. You know, if I'm preaching teamwork and they all go as a team swimming, it's hard to get mad at them. Because I did see them coming back to the, I happened to be at the front desk of the hotel, and I'm looking straight at the security camera. I see nothing but a mob of boys coming back in the building, and I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. These are my guys. Where are they going? But don't get any ideas for the next ones, because teamwork doesn't get you out of all problems. On the girls, you know, they're famous bathroom birthday showers. They think I never get, because I don't obviously come in the locker room. But when some people come out drenched, it wasn't because they forgot how to take a shower. It's because, you know, an extra birthday celebration that, again, they always think they could pull a fast one on Whitner, but I'm a step ahead of them all the time.
Nunca se rindan. A pesar de cómo está el marcador o está la situación, las lesiones, que nunca se rindan.
Pues que le echen muchas ganas y que dejen todo en el campo, porque siempre dejando todo en el campo se puede llegar a muy lejos. Pueden llegar hasta district, hasta más. Yo sé que si siguen echándole ganas, van a llegar muy lejos.
¿Qué les podría decir? Que le echen ganas, que se pasa de volada el tiempo. Los 4 años vuelan. Y pues otra más, no perdemos contra Horizon.
Pues que le sigan echando ganas, que nunca bajen. Si este año nomás llegamos hasta area, pues que next year lleguemos más lejos, que siga la tradición, que nunca bajen.
No, pues que le echen ganas. Yo sé que va a salir algo bueno o positivo. Que le echen ganas, han visto nuestros juegos, han visto el nivel de fútbol. Y pues, ojalá a todos les vaya bien y que se le sigan echando.
That I know that they have what it takes to go to state. They just need the will. They need to play as a team, like as a team. And leave the drama, leave everything, and just listen to the coaches, listen to their other teammates, and just give it their all, because they can do it.
To give it their all, just dedicate yourself and just give it your all when you're in that field. You never know when it's your last game.
I'm pretty sure they already know how much I love them and how much I care for them, but I would just want them to know that if they ever need something, I'm always a call away. They could call me on my way to San Antonio, I'll come back, and I promise to come watch them play and support them like I did all this time.
For our seniors, you know, first, you know, thank you for their contribution to the program here at Eastlake. You'll always be remembered. There's a first for everything in life, and they're the first here for the Eastlake soccer program. Second, I hope it was a great run that we helped create here. Fell short for our goals this year, but I think overall we've left a legacy. And what I wish to all you seniors is reach out for everything you want to do. Go for all your dreams, you know, go for your goals. Don't let nobody stop you. Come back and visit, come back and share what it takes to be successful in life as you grow and mature every year. After this year, come back and share with others what it means to have been an Eastlake soccer player. I wish them all nothing but the best to themselves, to their families, and hope they become great, productive citizens for and everything they do. And I hope all their dreams come true. And I'm going to miss them, and I love all the seniors here at Eastlake High School. First, I want to thank all the parents, all the community support that we have here at East Lake High School. I mean, wow, our fan base is awesome. And they come out in numbers to all our games. So thank you to all the parents and all the fans that come and support us. I want to thank Coach Villa for establishing the tradition here with coaching the boys, and me being able to take over such a great group of boys who have come to graduate as young men. And I really want to thank you for that. And I want to thank my coaching staff, because between three of us to coach four teams, two JVs and two varsities, it takes a special group. And then I think within our coaching staff, nothing is better than what we do. We are great coaches, we have great players, we have a great team, we have a great community support, and we got great support from our administration. So I want to thank all of them. But first of all, I think as a coaching staff, we want to thank our family, our wives, our kids, who know the sacrifices we do to come here and give to our other kids in our life, which is our athletes. And I want to thank our families for allowing us to be here multiple hours of the day and evening and night. That way, our program is number one in the city and will be number one in the state. So everybody, it's thank you for making East Lake soccer a tradition, and players who are coming back, we got work to do, and we'll get it done. Next year we're gonna get it done, and we're gonna win big.